Another one of Howard's all-stars was the ukulele-playing pop singer, Tiny Tim.
Tiny Tim was in my top five of guests. Like, great. Tiny Tim, again, like Underdog Woman, like Crackhead Bob. Tiny Tim was not putting anything on. He was the real deal. This wasn't an orchestrated, I'm a freaky guy kind of thing. He was the real deal. And Tiny Tim is a radio guest. Forget about all that music stuff and singing in the falsetto and all of that. I don't care about that. The man had tremendous information about products. And he used a lot of products. He had very specific opinions on them. And it was fascinating to hear him talk about products like adult diapers and cleaning equipment. And he was obsessive compulsive. And he spoke about everything so honestly. Masturbation, sexuality. And there wasn't a false bone in his body. He was phenomenal.
Penn and Teller's Penn Jillette.
Tiny Tim was fascinating, and Tiny Tim was mentally ill, you know. Probably very likely had Asperger's syndrome. That's a diagnosis by a non-professional. I'm just making it up. But he had clearly many, many issues. And he had a magic power that when he came in contact with the most cynical, most aggressive, most self-absorbed people, they stopped being that way. And it's fascinating to see with real monsters like Bing Crosby and Frank Sinatra. But then when he walks out with Johnny Carson and Johnny becomes a different person, when Bob Dylan says, "The only real person I ever met," when John Lennon melts, and then all of that happens in this period of time from 67 to 71. Then there's a lull, and then he comes on Howard. But now it's not a minute hunk, a 2 minute hunk. Now it's not the tabloids. Now he's in a room with Howard. And Howard says, you know, Jesus Christ or something. And Tiny, who was, you know, part of his mental illness was he was a Christian. And Howard backs down to him. It's an amazing moment. He doesn't back down because Tiny wins. Tiny can't win. I have the highest opinion of Howard in the world. But the reason Tiny doesn't win, it's also someone else's show. You never play another man's game. That's your basic Carney rule. When I go in there, Howard's running the shop. You can't win. All you have to do is tie, you know, help out. Tiny takes a stand, and Howard chooses, and that's important to know, chooses to back down. And the moment he chooses to back down, he enters a whole other territory. And there's a kind of compassion and straight talking that we never hear. And Howard's still fast, and he's still funny, and he still commands the show and stays close to the mic for the inverse square law and keeps his voice going right. And he's still as showbiz blitzy as he's ever been, you know, a pro. Something else happens at the same time. There's this moment where a really successful, big-swinging dick showbiz guy is talking to someone who's truly different. Not a drunken midget, not a retard, not a star who's so full of themselves they're insane, but someone who is sincerely different. And when those two hearts meet, it's pretty powerful. I think it's Howard at his best. Of course, you don't get that moment without everything else Howard's done. It means nothing out of context.
I'm telling you the truth the way it is. I thank Jesus Christ for saving my soul, and I've gone through the whole rigmarole.
All right.
This is not mentioned on this show.
I understand.
Now, I know you're a light, funny show here.
Yes.
But you should tell your listeners that Jesus Christ does rule my life, and I have sinned like everyone else, but I thank you for letting
me out.
Well,
we would
that.
If you give us the chance.
Right. I'd like to say that. I was about to say it.
No, you wouldn't have, because you would have talked over me.
Jesus, I want to pray to Jesus right now. You know, you've changed me. I want to pray to Jesus if I may. All right. Tiny's getting upset.
I think Tiny is getting upset.
I think I am getting upset, because you're taking Jesus Christ's name in vain.
Oh.
It's one thing to talk about other things, but you're supposed to be normal and on the show, and you're taking his name in vain, and I reject it. I despise that.
Oh. Oh, wait a second. Oh,
when did you do that?
I don't know. I'm not sure when.
See?
I'm going to pray to Jesus now myself.
Bless me, Christ. That's right.
Bless me, Christ. Right. Put Tiny's ukulele in his mouth, for God's sake. if I can say that.
I reject the fact that you're making fun of Jesus Christ.
I'm not making fun of him.
Yes, you are.
I'm not.
You're mocking his name. You don't believe in him.
I do believe in him.
No, you don't.
Well, I kind of.
Well, now, Tiny. You can get into an argument with Tiny Tim, huh?
I don't know. I'm getting nervous here.
Oh, my.
Even Tiny's angry with me.
Oh.
Well, I am at this point, at all of you here, because you're mocking Jesus Christ.
I think it was Robin who was mocking Jesus, if you ask me.
Both both of you were, in a sense.
I'm sorry.
All right, Tiny, we apologize. All right, I'll give you a plug. That'll make you feel better.
It won't make me feel better.
Yes, it will.
What I'm trying to bring here, I told you the truth here, to praise Jesus Christ. I'm not hiding it like so many people do, and then you find the press come out and reveal it. Because I have a higher source to answer to.
All right.
You're talking to the world's biggest sinner, but I thank Jesus Christ.
You're not the world's biggest sinner, Tiny.
You ain't kidding, I am.
No, I like you. I don't care if you're mad at me. I love you.
I'm not mad at anyone.
Nice, you are. But I saw you. You were getting upset.
The name of Jesus Christ is being taken in vain on this show.
It was Fred.
And the FCC allows it.
Yeah. Thanks a lot. Well, let's dial him up. Maybe he can report me. Oh, boy, Tiny.
I mean, one thing is fun and the other thing is not. Now, Jesus Christ's name has been sworn and taken in vain every minute on this show here. You know?
Well, I really think it was Robin's fault.
I didn't do anything.
Hey, I got to sit in here with him.
She didn't say too much. It was really,
it was really me?
Yes, it was, Mrs. Stern.
But Jackie wrote it.
I did not.
Well, about that, Tiny.
Boy, oh boy.
I gotta get out of here. I'm
now,
getting
can
nervous.
You all calm down?
Tiny, come on, Tiny.
Calm. I'm very calm.
No,
you're
calm
angry,
now.
And I don't like it.
Yeah, it's not, it doesn't become you.
All right, but I've never seen a show where Jesus Christ's name is taken in vain.
Really?
I mean, everyone who listens to your show is thinking one thing when I'm trying to bring out the truth and honesty on this show instead of hiding it because he knows I'm letting the listeners know all these things in a book anyway. But the fact is, I'm trying to also say how Jesus Christ saved my life.
When did I exactly get...
Keeps me from fornication. Right. I can look at all the pretty women nude and think pure thoughts.
Right.
I thank him for guiding me in that light.
I lost a tremendous radio guest, but the world lost the greatest person. I mean, this guy was the greatest. He was a real find. And you know what I'm proud of? Tiny Tim, of course, had great fame back in the 60s, or was it the early 70s, whenever Laughing was on and Johnny Carson. But I was able to bring him back in a genuine way and sort of help reinvent him. He was great on the radio. So Tiny Tim, I greatly miss him. And you know what's sad, too? He could have lived longer. He refused to get surgery. You know, he would not have open-heart surgery. They said to him, you're going to die. You're going to die of a heart attack. He didn't care. He did not want to be operated on. And I think he was a very tragic guy, a very sad guy. I think he was ready to go, quite frankly. But he was wonderful. He had a real beauty about him.
Love forever true.
Well, this is a momentous occasion, Robin.
What is happening?
Well, it's been 5 years and 3 months. It's our fifth year anniversary. Tiny Tim has not appeared on this show for 5 years.
2/9/89. February 9th of 89 was his last appearance.
Tiny, I didn't realize it had been that long.
Tiny walked out angry at me, but there's been a bit of a reconciliation, I would say. I think a full reconciliation.
It's been very slow coming. You know, it was a step at a time.
Yeah, we kept calling Tiny was always one of the best guests. Guy's got a lot to say. But he abandoned us because evidently I had stepped over the line. But Tiny came in today. He said, tell Mr. Stern he can talk about anything.
Really?
Yeah, I think what had got me in trouble
He's
the last time.
He's an open book now, huh?
What got me in trouble the last time with Tiny was I brought up Jesus.
Yeah, you used the Lord's name in vain or something.
I thought Tiny was a Jewish guy. I didn't know. I don't know what the hell. I didn't know anyone got that uptight about it. But it got bad. It was a big argument on the air. It was great radio. But I never thought Tiny would stay away for 5 years. Did you?
No. I thought we had calmed him down because we talked to him after and tried to apologize.
Yeah.
Didn't work.
Didn't want to lose him. Hey, where's Tiny? Tiny, how you doing? 5 years since you've walked through that door.
Wow.
5 years, Tiny.
Good morning.
Unbelievable.
Thanks for having me again.
Oh, of course. What do you mean? We wanted to have you for a long time. That's Tiny Tim, everybody.
Yeah, it's you who weren't coming.
Thanks.
You know, Tiny, sometimes, you know, I get mad at Johnny Carson sometimes. I know you're very grateful to Johnny Carson, but I get mad at him sometimes because, like, when you were at the height of your popularity, you were selling millions of records. How many records did you sell?
First of all, Mrs. Stern, it's so nice being on your show again.
Oh.
And,
yeah, he'd like to say hello.
Oh, okay.
And thanks for having me. And I just want to say, you can say anything you want. You know, in 1989, when I said, you know, that I had that homosexual affair.
Yes.
You know, those things can happen. And I just, thank Jesus Christ for his blessings. But, you know, I just said the truth so fast that I was wondering, you know, if I was wise or not.
Right.
But it's always your best to tell the truth. And,
right.
You know, like Hebrew National Salami says, I have a higher source to answer to.
Hey, let me tell you something. Tiny is all man. I seen this guy. Here, let me explain what Tiny's talking about.
Yes.
Tiny's all man.
I didn't get the whole thing.
I see. Tiny's married a bunch of women.
Yeah.
This guy's had sex with some of the most beautiful. If anyone is
women.
No homo, it's
loves
Tiny Tim.
Women.
Loves women.
I will testify to that.
In fact, who does he show up with today, may I say?
Oh, yes.
From our New Year's Eve show, the Sunday woman, Miss Vanessa Warner.
Really?
Whoa. Yeah.
And she is wonderful.
What do you, how'd you hook up with her?
Well, after the, I'll tell you, after your fabulous show on New Year's Eve.
Thank you.
And thanks for having me on, because somebody pointed out from the Vicki Lawrence show afterwards that the two highest ratings of marriage and your show, I was happy to be on two highest ratings ever on the video show and your great video show and the Mr. Carson show.
Right. And let me I'm going to get back to the Johnny Carson point in 1 minute, because I see things differently than you do. I'll make it so you hate Johnny. Anyway, so the thing is, Tiny had left the show after 5 years, and Tiny today very graciously said, talk about anything. Tiny had felt that I had gone overboard that day in 1989. Right, Tiny?
No.
When I brought up the homosexuality. Tiny had one stupid experience where it was hardly an experience
at all,
and I kept harping on it. Tiny felt I was harping on it, and I didn't realize he was
getting...
Also,
you were just reading his book.
I was reading his book, and Tiny didn't want to give the impression that he was like some, you know, flaming homosexual or something. Yeah. He's a guy who's all man.
Yeah.
Probably hung like a fire hydrant. Am I correct, Tiny?
No.
Seriously.
No, the
ladies know.
You're not correct there.
Right. Really, I'm not? I always picture you as a large man.
But
you want me to talk about anyone?
But I will say, I will say, in all fairness,
go ahead.
What the Claridge Hotel says, smaller is friendlier.
That's right.
No, really. But I honestly, I praise the good Lord what I got. But the thing is, thank you for your nice words there.
Thank you.
And also, I was going to say that, I was grateful to be on two of the highest rated shows ever.
Thank you. But let me get back to it. Let me fill people in. Yes. So anyway, so then we got over that, and then Tiny got upset about it. Tiny's a very religious guy. Loves Jesus more than anyone.
The biggest sinner in the world I am.
Yeah.
I need help, though.
You're not a sinner. Why are you saying
Everyone's a sinner.
Tiny thinks it's sinning if he, like, even if he has sex with a woman before marriage.
Of course it's a sin if you believe what Tiny believes.
Tiny, that ain't no sin. Believe me. Nowadays, that's not a sin. Why are you a sinner? Why do you say you're a sinner?
Well, I constantly, as President Carter said, think of lust.
Right.
And
do you think that's sinning? Don't you think that's natural to think of women?
It's a natural thought that flows through, but I have to shove it off with my hand.
Really? Really? How many times a day are you shoving off?
Oh, I mean, you know, the thoughts.
Oh, the thoughts. I see. Now, are you with Vanessa Warner?
Are you an item?
Miss Warner, no.
I mean, is she your girlfriend?
No. Here's what, thanks for reminding me what I wanted to say.
Yeah.
After your show, she was very heartbroken that she didn't win.
Yeah. Loved her. I mean, you thought she was great.
I really believe she should have won.
Right.
She came up with originality. She was with the whipped cream there.
I was shocked that she didn't win.
But wait a minute, Tiny.
I thought that the judges went wild for her.
Well, saying you thought she should win,
you
gave her the same amount of votes as you did some of the other contestants.
Yeah, like the girl who won, you gave 5 points to, and you gave Vanessa 5 points.
Yeah, it was a tie, you know, from what I wrote down.
Right.
But I believe if the other one of them should have won, she should have won.
Right. But I'm just surprised. So you liked them almost both equally, but you like Vanessa a little more.
Yeah, because I thought, here's why.
Right.
Because I thought that, she was original in the way she presented her act.
I see. I'm surprised you didn't give her, like, more than, why didn't you give her more points than the other girl?
Because at the point, I didn't know if she was in the race anymore.
I see.
So I was using the other girl as second best.
I see. Face it. Who knows why? Yeah. Tiny was out of control. Now, he gave Robin 5 points.
Yeah.
And Robin wasn't even in the contest, right? Tiny didn't want to offend anyone. Now, I think the woman who won is very beautiful, but I knew that you really liked the Sunday girl. I thought that maybe you would have gotten a little more.
You were very upset that she didn't win.
But well, you're saying after the...
Second after Miss Warner.
Right. Yeah. So you're saying that after the contest, you needed to console her.
Well, no, I met her there.
Yeah.
I met her at the end, and I said, I told her, I think you should have won, and, you know, I voted for you, and she was very appreciative of that fact, and, you know, she was nice.
You took her back to your hotel?
No.
Really?
No,
so you haven't slept with her?
Oh, no.
Oh, you haven't? You would like to?
Oh, I beg your pardon?
You would like to?
Well, in marriage, these things are proper.
Right.
You know,
would you like to marry her?
Who wouldn't want to marry her?
She's here with you, I know.
Yeah, well, she's a wonderful woman. Any man who marries her would find a gem.
Really? But yeah. She has not expressed any sexual interest?
Oh, no.
I mean, you're a big star. I mean, certainly that she might be attracted to stardom. And
Well, the thing is, any time that I can help her, to be seen, it's a thrill.
Really?
Remember, I gave Helen Reddy her first big break.
You did?
In 1970, when I had her appear with me in Vegas at the Fremont Hotel for a week and a half. And the same with, you know, Paul Williams, you know.
So when you were at your height, Johnny Carson put you on. You had your wedding on there and all that kind of stuff. The second that he sensed that your record sales or something were slipping, boom, he cut you off. Never seen again. What kind of pal is that?
All right. Before I even answer that,
I
just want to get, I want to say, if I may, just to get this out of the way, that tonight I will be playing tonight.
Oh, yeah, I should plug you. Twilight Zone.
In Long Beach, at the Twilight Zone, formerly the Page Six.
Now, what are you going to be doing? You're going to be doing some of your songs?
Some songs down memory lane, and some rock songs with Mr. Michael Marlowe's orchestra, and some other acts there, so thanks for letting me mention that.
Right.
Going back to the Carson thing now, it is human nature,
right,
that when you're up there, the world wants it. When you're not, you have to try again and go back to the minor leagues.
Right.
And so, while it is true, there is a point that from human nature, after 1969, and I started slipping again, that I had to go back to the minor leagues,
right,
and try to make it again.
Right, right.
And so, I don't have any...
Can Johnny help you a little bit? Or
no,
he only uses you up and he throws you out.
For him.
No, but I didn't ask for any. I wouldn't want him to help me.
Really?
In fact, the managers I had at that time, one of them, may rest in peace, Roy Radin, who died... asked him, and he gave me two shots in 74 and 79, and I didn't want him to ask him then. I mean, I said, if I have to make it on my own, and then he'll use me again.
Right.
In this business, you know, you're as good as your last
year. That's fair. That's fair. Yeah. That's tiny, a good judge of what
apparently
the show business
Johnny
is about.
Johnny did give him some shots.
Yeah.
Two shots.
Now, what are you doing now? You moved out of New York City?
Yeah, 74 and 79.
Yeah, what do you do?
Oh, no, it's all right. But after 79, he never used me again, because I rolled on the floor when I did Do You Think I'm Sexy?
Right.
And a belly button showed, and that was the end of that.
Oh, wait
a
second,
let me get this straight. You were on the Carson show. You did Do You Think I'm Sexy?
Well, and I rolled on the floor.
You rolled around on the floor to get into it, like a dance move.
Absolutely. Mr. Letterman was on that show.
Right.
He was a guest at the show with Tony Randall in 79.
Everyone must have been stunned because you had never done any dancing to your music before. This was probably a first.
Well, I was just rolling on the floor, and my belly button showed.
And you feel that the sexiness of that, because it was taboo to show your belly button, turned off Johnny?
Well, I didn't mean to do it. It's just that the shirt slipped. I only saw it on the rerun afterwards. I think Mr. Cordova gave me a tough look.
Freddie Cordova.
It was a little bold for that show.
Right.
But, you know, as you know, you always play to win.
Yeah.
And basically, in 79, I had to do something.
Right.
And
you got a little carried away.
The crowd loved it, but
right,
nobody else did.
Wow.
He did it.
Wow.
But he's a wonderful...
Now, you would think that would be a showstopper.
Yeah.
I mean, Tiny doing something
rolling
new.
Rolling on the floor.
Yeah, it was the first time you'd probably even done a rock song on there.
That's right.
Yeah. Well... And you didn't have LSD for breakfast that day? It wasn't like something was wild? Or
I never touched
drugs. You never touched drugs. Never did drugs ever, right?
No, never. The only thing I do is drink beer.
Right. I know. You like... in fact, I saw you out there drinking a nice draft. Do you like the product?
Not only...
What do you think of that product? It's good, isn't it?
I like the ice beer, but I love Molson's. Molson's ice.
Is that right?
Are you sponsored by Bud?
Well, yes. Ice Draft.
Well, they shouldn't feel too bad. They got a lot of great beers besides that.
All right. Well, there you go.
Great. Oh, I'm sorry about
Tiny,
that.
Now, I notice that you're very honest when you discuss products. One of the things, Tiny used to come on the show and discuss what he loved. I know you still love Aunt Millie's tomato sauce?
Yes, but I can't get it in Des Moines, Iowa.
You moved to Iowa. Tiny has an unusual eating regimen, and I even said to him, Tiny, you ought to endorse some of these products. He says, no, I would never endorse a product because I'm honest to a fault about what are good products. Mm-hmm. In fact, one of the companies wanted to send you some free product, I think, and you turned it down.
Yes. In fact, I thank you, Mr. Stern, for letting me be on your show all these times. I mentioned these things like Bounty towels. Right. And then I found a better one than that. Which
better than Bounty?
Yes.
Did you get
what
this in Iowa?
What are you doing now?
No, I got this here in New York and then in Iowa, too.
Right.
It's called Job Squad.
Job Squad.
See, Tiny turned me on to Bounty. Now I'm going to have to go out and get
So you're stuff. Saying that Bounty was your favorite towel. When you used to come on the show, you always talked about Bounty towel.
Right, it was.
Tiny is a clean bug.
Yes.
Can I say that?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're cleanly.
What was the cleaner he used to use all the time?
A big fan.
The cleaner that you used all the time. Your special Ajax?
Comet or Ajax?
Oh, yes. I right now I like Ajax better because Comet made a bad mistake in taking the grit out of their powder.
Right.
And Ajax still has a little grit in it. You know, Bonhomie is great for polishing things.
I use that.
But every tub needs a scratch.
Needs
in it.
A grit.
Sure, because otherwise you can't get, you know, the if I may say that word, the scum out.
Right. Please, honey.
From the bad tub. And so basically, but right now I like Zud. I like Zud.
Zud is a product. And I've never heard of this product.
It's great. I like that better than both of them.
The Tiny really is a clean for you. You're one of those guys, you shower 5 times a day. You're always very clean, and you always oil yourself. And I always found his regimen fascinating. That's why I always loved to have Tiny on, because aside from being a great entertainer, the man has a regimen. He has a...
he was always just very clean.
He always was clean, and he was very open about what his lifestyle in terms of what he ate. It was very fascinating.
Now, it seems to recall that the spaghetti that you used the Millie sauce on wasn't really cooked.
No, it wasn't spaghetti. He used it on seeds. Am I correct?
No, I drank it from the bottle.
Right. You drink the Aunt Millie's directly. Right.
And also, you know, it was very good. It had no sugar in it. I can't get it, you know, in Des Moines. However, right now, I will. Ragu has come out with a pretty good, you know, good tomato sauce has seeds in it that you can chew. And also, it has, you know, if it's a real good one, it has tomato peels in it that you can chew as well.
Let me get this straight, Tiny. You moved to Iowa. You got sick of New York. You said, I got to slow down. This is I'm going to move to Iowa. Now, in Iowa, do they all recognize? They must recognize you in Iowa.
Well, I didn't get sick in New York. I was concerned just that my new management was out there, and they paid for everything for me to go there.
Because it's an unusual move. I mean, Iowa's not the show business mecca that it once was, you know. A lot of people try to get out of Iowa to get into show business.
But I love Des Moines.
Was it a retirement of sorts?
No, I could never retire.
No.
I mean, I've been living off the edge since 1970.
Right.
But it's just that they took care of everything. The finances ran out here, and basically, I live in a lovely hotel in downtown Des Moines.
Lives in a hotel.
You always live in a hotel.
Yeah.
Now why not invest some money in a, you know, like here you're going to be at the Twilight Zone tonight in Long Beach. You get paid, you invest a little, you know, you got money, you take a little of that money and maybe buy a little place out in Iowa or something.
Oh, no, I've been every job pays the rent since 1970.
Right.
So you live
from hand to mouth, right?
Oh, so here, I mean.
You didn't sock away any of the dough when you sold it?
I never saw it.
Really?
My 68, 69, I was managed by Roy Silver, same with Mr. Cosby. I wish someone would ask Mr. Cosby these questions as to what happened when he robbed Mr. Cosby's money. Mr. Cosby had to make it back again from 1972.
You're saying that you accuse your manager of taking all the money?
Well, I hate, I know the word accused. It's just that he just manipulated it wrong and basically...
all gone. Never saw it done.
Right.
Wow. Wow, that's sad. That's horrible.
Well, it is.
How do you live with that? Does it drive you crazy?
Well, I thank Jesus Christ for his blessings for the spiritual strength, but it's just I had to have the strength to go on, and I remember great ball players, you know, from Eddie Stanky to Maury Wills, you know.
A lot of the black guys, boxers.
Billy Martin.
Right.
Who hustled and hustled.
A lot of black guys.
A lot of black guys.
And Billy Martin.
Yes.
And picked themselves up again and started again.
And that's how you felt. You said, hey, look, I got to go. But you know the odds of making it in this business are very rare. Even the most talented of people, it's difficult.
It's a crapshoot.
It's a crapshoot. Well, listen. As luck would have it, he didn't steal your ukulele, so you're still in business. Am I correct?
Yeah, but you know, the world knew about that since 1970,
right.
And Miss Vicky did. But you know, I've been fortunate to get work all the time.
And then you had all those marriages that had to cost
you a
bunch of bucks, right?
I'll answer that.
Yeah.
First of all, Mr. Knight, you know, my Glenn Knight, my agent,
right,
was very fortunate to get me back. You know, and you were very nice to have me in that wonderful New Year's show.
Yeah, no problem.
And basically, thank you. And so, basically, they've always been getting me work there, you know, with headline talent and all the rest. And thanks for that show again because I got a couple of jobs.
Good. And when you went, but I'm saying when you got married each time, you had to pay out alimony or you had to give away some of your fortune, right? I mean, even no matter how much you had left, right?
Well, no, Miss Vicky was so happy to get out of the marriage, she just left.
You're right. And you're married now, right?
Well, the second one, Miss Jan, another beautiful girl.
Because I see her. Now, the second one was not the one at the pay-per-view event, was she?
Yes.
Oh, that was Miss Jan?
Yeah.
Now, Miss Jan, very beautiful woman.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, right. Miss Jan was there with you.
Yes.
And she's on the videotape, as a matter of fact.
Yeah.
You see her sitting there next to Tiny at one point backstage. And the thing is that, I don't know, are you two together or is it over?
We're together in name.
In name only.
And only, you
what
know.
What happened?
What the hell went wrong this time?
That's a great question.
Yeah. Beautiful woman.
Thank you. Oh,
and she hangs around with you all the time.
She seems to be into you, Tiny.
Well, yeah. She's wonderful.
Doesn't she want to come down here today? And
She's coming down. She said she would.
When she here, so it seems to be friendly. I mean, you see each other.
Well, she has the most greatest mind of any woman I've ever met who is beautiful.
Right.
A lot of beautiful women, you know, the mind is vacant. We all have our talents.
Right.
But the thing is, this is a gigantic mind. However, my problem with her, and, you know, I told her behind her back, in front of her back, that basically I believe she's had affairs while we were married.
I see.
And I cannot take that.
Yeah.
And basically...
I don't blame you.
If she had told me before the marriage or during the marriage, this is the way I am, take me or leave me, then I would have said, well, thanks for your honesty.
You believe in faithfulness.
Absolutely.
Right.
But I also believe this. If I could fall in love with a woman of the night... Someone I can meet on 42nd Street.
Well, a prostitute.
And it doesn't matter what their label is.
Right.
It's what the heart is.
Right.
And she can become the greatest wife.
Right.
And you can meet a girl from Main Street and become the worst wife.
You're a romantic.
I hope I can say
yes,
that.
Yes, absolutely.
And I can honestly tell you, Mr. Sherman's Quivers, and gentlemen here.
Mr. Jackie. It's all right.
Mr. Jackie, right.
Mr. Martian. Yeah, right. You can call Mr. Martian.
Mr. Martian. And basically, I can honestly tell you that, if she would have told me the way she was, I probably would have taken it.
You would have accepted it. You would have accepted it. But to have a surprise like that all of a sudden, wait a second. It's a surprise. Yeah. Poor Tiny. You can't even find love. Can't find the right love.
Was it only men?
Well, last night.
You did find love last night?
Oh,
who did you find?
I have it right here.
What?
I can't mention the name because, you know, just found. But she was so nice to go out with me last night.
Yes.
And she poured this bottle of beer
in
my glass, and I keep the bottle for her.
Wow.
Miss Julia.
Really? You met a girl?
You met someone last night.
Miss Julia. Are you going to ask her out on a date?
Well, only she wants to go with me again.
Right. Well, I'm sure she will.
She has my number.
Hey, Tiny's going to be at the Twilight Zone tonight. Now, you want to see a show, you go to Long Beach tonight at the Twilight Zone and let Tiny entertain you.
Yes.
And Tiny, let me take a break here. And then if you would, stay here because there's so much I need to know about, you know, what you're eating out in Iowa, all the new products you're using. People really haven't heard from you in 5 years on this show, and they certainly want to hear all of this.
Am I wrong? Did you really not eat uncooked spaghetti?
Oh, I couldn't eat uncooked spaghetti, but it was... It was about 7/8 uncooked. In other words, I could chew the grains. It was very, very firm.
It's a whole tiny thing. I want to know. I mean, there's so much to know.
Congratulations on your governorship.
Thank you, Tiny. I know you ran for mayor of New York. I hope to get in. That's all I can say. All right, anyway, hey, let me take a little break here. Oh, let me tell you about a movie, first of all. You got a video player out there in Iowa?
No, but I can get one.
You can get one.
Yeah.
Well, I suggest you rent a movie that I liked. Now, I don't know how you, I mean, you might be very particular about movies. Maybe you don't like violent movies or something like that. I don't know, Tiny. I say the more violence, the better. Nothing wrong with seeing that in the cinema. Now, I rented this movie that I recommend to you. It's called A Perfect World. Have you heard of this?
Very likely.
Mr. Clint Eastwood directed it. And
how would you have rented this?
What?
How could you have...
Well, I say I rented it so I can relate to the people. I was sent to me by the movie company.
Because it just came out.
All right, but just pretend. Oh, come on, will you? Doing a commercial. Oh, Tiny, you know, explain show business to Robin, will you? Oh.
You know, either you get looks or a mind.
All right.
I'm very vacant.
You're vacant up there with all the good looks. She is vacant. She's one of those vacant, good-looking people.
Let me tell you, if I may, yes. Without flattering anyone, Miss Quivers is a lovely woman.
Oh, my
goodness. Oh, she really is.
Her charms do not escape any man.
If I may say, that's the most underrated forgetfulness in the years when I've seen her.
Yes,
very,
always.
Very lovely woman.
I don't know if you're a breast man, but anyone who is would certainly marvel at her two beautiful.
Believe you me.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And if we're sinning, then sinning ain't wrong. Am I correct?
Of course it is.
Anyway, let me just tell you, Tiny, I want to recommend this to you. Do you watch movies in your hotel room?
Very rarely. The last movie I watched was, I had to see this movie, Indecent Proposal.
Yes, now, how do you like that Demi Moore, huh? Oh, yeah. Now, what would you do to her? You well, would sin, right?
No, I would. I would.
Yes.
I would just be grateful I'm with her.
Yeah. Tiny, you make sex so dirty. It's unbelievable. Let me tell you about this movie. you see Robin's braids? See, she braids her hair?
No, I didn't see that because she has the ear.
In fact, some of the braids are made from Tiny's hair, actually.
Tiny
donated some.
Tiny's hair.
Very, very sweet of you, Tiny. let me tell you, Perfect World is Clint Eastwood directed Kevin Costner in this movie. It's a story of a guy who escapes from prison, but would you say he has a heart of gold in a sense?
He's sort of like a nice guy, but a little bent.
Right. You got to see it. Clint Eastwood is very good in it. He has to chase down Kevin Costner. And you end up identifying a little bit with Kevin Costner,
yes,
the criminal.
Yes.
It's just very well done. It's really good. It's got a lot of a lot of good action, a lot of people getting shot and stuff.
A lot of chases.
A lot of chases, this kind of stuff. You would love it, Tiny.
Well, I did see, come to think of,
Mr. Martian.
Definitely, I saw this one with Whitney Houston he was in.
Whitney Houston.
Oh, the bodyguard.
Yeah. Oh, what a voice she's got.
Yeah, oh yeah, she's
what
good.
What a voice.
Ah, your voice is better.
No,
believe
never.
You. Believe you. Do you do that song at all, I Will Always Love You?
Listen, I want to kill it.
No, do you ever do I Will Always Love You?
I don't know that. Yeah, but
you don't know yet?
She did a great job in that picture, but so did he.
Yeah.
I mean, he rubbed off on me. These things happen. So when I go to the movies, in the old years, I used to sit alone, and sometimes these actors would rub off on me. And he rubbed off on me because
sometimes you come out of the theater, you feel like Kevin Costner. Am I correct?
Right,
yes, yes.
Beautifully
yes.
Understood.
Right.
And for the next few days, I was.
You were bodyguarding.
No, standing in the crowd and looking at everyone.
Right.
You know, like I was looking.
Like
at,
he did. You become the character.
Well, what a voice she had. I mean,
then you should rent A Perfect World. You will like
love it.
You will like it.
Thank God.
I think Tiny's been living on Mars. I don't believe on Iowa. I don't believe it, Tiny.
Oh, it's so beautiful there.
You might have become an alien.
Oh, it's so beautiful.
Well, is it your dream to move to Iowa, too?
Yes, that is my dream. I want to talk to you about my dream. No, it really is. I will talk to you about my dream when I come back. And Tiny will give us some more details of what he's been up to, because it's been 5 years.
Yes,
certainly a lot has happened.
Yes, we've talked to him. It's true.
There have been various women in his life. There's been many things going on. And, of course, tonight, it all culminates at the Twilight Zone in Long Beach, where you can see Tiny. We'll be back. The Hauser Show. Jackie has a new CD out, Wild Comedy CD, $10, free shipping and handling. Price includes full color catalog. Call 1-800-323-5464. Friday night, May 27th, we'll be at the Stress Factory in New Brunswick, New Jersey. For information and dirty jokes, you call 516-9221. Tiny Tim tonight at the Twilight Zone. Now, the Twilight Zone used to be called Page 6. They changed the name just today.
Ah.
And that'll be in Long Beach. Tiny will be there tonight doing a bunch of his songs. Maybe you'll actually do You Think I'm Sexy with Rolling Around on the Floor. People would probably like to see that.
Oh, thank you.
Think about it.
Thanks. While I was in New York, I heard your show.
Right.
Man, it might have been 91 or 90 or maybe early part of 92.
At any point while you were staying away from the show, did you want to come on?
Sure.
You did, but you felt you had to stay away.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, are you kidding?
Right.
You really felt you couldn't call us and you...
I would never bother you. Like Johnny Carson, I mean, you know...
We kept calling you, though, you know.
Well, thanks for doing that.
Right.
And because, you know, you don't need me, really. And I'm grateful...
I need you. Listen, let me tell you something. By the way, Tiny, as a tribute to our reunion today, is wearing the exact same outfit he wore 5 years ago on our last show together. Which, by the way, I can't thank you enough.
Well, I just want to say, I was in 1991 and 92, I was hearing your radio shows anyway, but Boy Gary had hemorrhoids.
Yes.
I remember that very well.
Isn't that interesting that you remember that?
And they
stuck out of a lot of places.
And, of course, I've had them, and I always clean the area with soap and water every time it happens.
Did you read my book?
Yeah, I bought it, yes.
Did you read about what word for word. Did you read my advice about hemorrhoids?
No, I didn't see that.
Same thing as you. I said soap and water, only three wipes.
But here's my suggestions now.
Thank you, Tony.
So first of all, the hemorrhoids, I bet you 10 to 1 that his diet consists of the normal diets from cheese to hamburgers to steaks. These things are like gum in an engine of a car. They can't come out. They have no fiber.
And there was too much pushing going on.
That's right.
Right. Which it's like giving birth.
Which can strain the veins.
Right.
Now, my suggestion here is the diet has to be changed to beans, to apples, to all the raw fruits. Must stay away from any cheeses, eggs, and everything.
Yes.
That's good advice. And after the hemorrhoids get its, after the stomach has a chance to only evacuate fruits and beans, which is great fiber.
I love medical advice.
Beans. Yeah. Well, then he can cleanse himself not only with soap and water. Sometimes I put cream there and cleanse it off like the face so it doesn't get too harsh. Very gently.
I don't want to think about Tiny putting cream there.
Cold cream.
Yes, right.
Really? Cold cream?
That's right.
Are you kidding me?
Cleanse it with cream sometimes instead of soap and water because sometimes it's a little harsh with the acid of the soap.
Right.
But after that, and I don't want nothing from these people.
Right.
I'm waiving everything.
Right.
After it's all cleansed, after his diet comes back with raw fruits and
what is the product?
And beans, after it's all cleansed,
yes.
after it's clean, is evacuated from all.
Yes, go ahead. Come on, this is a build-up. Yes,
then
yes.
I used Pazo.
Pazo.
That's P-A-Z-O.
Do you use your finger when you apply that, or
no?
What
very
is
gently.
Pazo?
Yeah, it's made by I think it's made by Bristol Myers. I'm not sure, or one of the companies.
Maybe that's how you lost your wife. Too much Pazo.
Oh, no. But it's after the system is cleansed.
Right.
I have it no more, but I use it now even like a cream.
What do you use that with? Do you put a finger towel?
Very gently on my fingers.
Really?
Very gently.
I don't want to think about it.
And as far as toilet tissue is concerned,
go ahead. What is your?
I always use Charmin. Charmin.
Right.
I don't want nothing with it. It's very soft, very gentle.
Yes.
Very gentle. And you can always cleanse with witch hazel as well. Dickinson's witch hazel, the original one in the yellow label. And
look at the command of products this guy has.
I will tell you, these are great. The greatest thing that's come out.
Go ahead.
I want nothing from these people.
Right.
I don't want a commercial.
Right.
Because I found something
else. Not looking for payment. Right.
No money or anything.
Right. Go ahead.
Not a thing.
I won't insult you with money.
The greatest soap that's come out. I use it today. I haven't missed a shower since December 20th, 1989.
You missed a shower in 1989?
On December 20th.
How did that happen?
Oh, I don't know.
But it was a bad day.
It was a bad day.
But the thing is, I'm using Jergens body shampoo instead of soap.
Now, let me get this straight. Let me understand it so I don't get it wrong. You buy a bottle of shampoo.
It's called body shampoo.
Body shampoo.
By Jergens.
And you don't even use bars of soap anymore.
No more. Except on the face.
You just use Jergens body soap and you
shampoo.
And you wipe this all over your body?
It's called Jergens body shampoo. It's like a soap. It eliminates all soap. It's so easy in the shower. Three latherings a day. And it is the most greatest
Tiny
soap
is
I've
one clean
used.
Dude. Three
yes,
latherings
yes.
a day.
Yes.
I can't see why
well,
anyone...
Well, that is why you see Tiny Skin.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful.
Well, yeah, we should go through Tiny's skin regimen. Tiny, actually, lotions. But, Tiny, if you're tight on money and stuff, it must be hard for you to buy all these lotions and shampoos.
No, I still work. You know, I'm always working,
right.
So I can delve here and there. But definitely on the face, I praise the good Lord on oil of Olay. I have, right now, I have...
You do have beautiful skin,
yes.
If I may say so, Tiny. I mean, yeah. You do, yeah. Beautiful complexion.
It's true.
Yeah. Well, you know, your hard work is not being unnoticed.
Not a blemish.
That's right. Not a blemish on you. God bless you.
Well, thank you. Yeah. So being near a 65, I get
you're kidding.
I get a thrill when people say...
Hey, Jackie, I told you Tiny was in his 60s.
Look, Jackie, look at you.
Jackie. Okay. Jackie, you're in your 60s. You're going to cave in. Tell Jackie about this, yes.
And so definitely, I just want to say that I have three moisturizers on right now.
Wow.
Lake came out with a new renewal cream, which is unbelievable.
Right.
And I use that at night in the morning, plus the lotion, plus the sensitive skin or the Olay.
Right. And so you don't find all these chemicals on your face bother you? They're very. You say this helps.
Well, I cleanse at least 8 times a day with oil of Olay's pump cream.
Now, let me get this straight, Tiny, because you really devote most of your time to cleaning yourself.
Well,
I wonder when he gets time to work.
A large portion. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You have to be in show business. He couldn't hold a regular 9-to-5 job. Seriously, you do a lot of cleaning all day.
Well, no, it's at one time 8 times a day.
You have a bit of a fetish, though, right? I mean, would you consider yourself a little bit obsessive, the way you clean the tub and the clean... You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you've got a real condition there, right?
Oh, same thing when I go out eating in clubs and restaurants. I always either carry a plastic fork.
Oh, look at that. You got a plastic fork on.
Yeah, I ask for plastic utensils.
You have, you have germ phobia.
Well, it's not in a way, but only because that so many people get colds, they eat the same metal spoons,
right,
and it's not really washed, where plastic forks and spoons are sanitary.
Like, I even noticed, like, Robin kissed you hello. Did that upset you?
No, but
I've been careful not to shake your hand or anything. You know, I'm very careful around you.
Well, I was a little bit afraid. Yeah. I didn't know whether I was doing the wrong thing.
This has nothing to do with sanitation.
When you kissed him, I almost went out of my mind. I said, oh, poor Tony's going to have to oil Olay for the next 3 hours. You know what I'm saying?
Wonderful.
Okay. Really, it was.
Oh, she's wonderful.
Believe me, Robin doesn't get sick, so you're safe there. Very healthy girl.
She's wonderful.
Very regular.
But that's what happens.
No hemorrhoids.
By the way, I got rid of my anal fissure, just the way you said.
Oh, really?
It's in my book.
Oh, well,
it's all there. That's why I was
that book, by the way.
Top seller, because I revealed these things.
And also because it was excellently written.
Thank you.
Whoever the writer was...
Well, wait a second, right.
Whoever the writer was.
I mean, well, you don't think I'm capable? It's fine.
There was a ghostwriter you mentioned.
Not a ghostwriter. I had someone who helped me, and I described his role, Larry Ratzel Sloman, but certainly I wrote
that
it.
I didn't know that.
Yes.
Because I had assumed that he had written that because he said that in the beginning of the book...
No, I said that Ratzel collaborated with me and helped me put all my materials together and certainly assisted me.
Well, someone said in the book then that he wanted to write it the way you spoke.
No, I said that.
That was me. That's all right. Hey, Tiny, listen.
That was great. Then it was written beautifully.
Thank you. Obviously, I didn't communicate it to you, though. You're not insulting me, believe me.
But it's very hard for me to absorb.
Now, let me get back to your life. I'm more fascinated by you, Tiny. And by the way, Tiny will be at the Twilight Zone tonight, formerly Page Six. Robin in Long Beach. It's
going
to be a big show. I'm going.
I wanted to ask Tiny about his hair.
Hair care? Oh. Well, we're going to get to that. First, I want to know about his regimen. In other words, you moved off to Iowa, right? Tiny Tim leaves New York, goes to Iowa. Put down that sign, Fred. I'm talking to Tiny.
Very good.
I'm going to learn things today. This man is oil of a laying six times a day. This is nothing to laugh at. You're out to Iowa. You live in this hotel. Now, the hotel cleaning staff probably never cleans the room to your liking. True? Let's be honest. They can't hear you anyway.
I would tell them. They do a nice job, but naturally I don't expect perfection.
Right. But you expect perfection from your own cleaning.
Right.
Yeah. So you have to, after they straighten up the room, you have to clean it as well. Am I correct?
Yes, I will clean it. Before I go out of any hotel, at least I'll make sure it's clean before I go.
Right. And when you're in the hotel in Iowa, you got to make sure. I mean, you must have your own sheets. You don't let them wash the sheets.
Oh, no. I don't sleep on sheets.
You don't?
My lights are always on. I never turn the lights off.
Now, why is that?
Well, I learned a lesson in Florida back in 85.
Bugs.
I looked up in a clean Holiday Inn. I looked up in the ceiling at 3 in the morning. There were beetle bugs on top of the ceiling. I haven't slept with the lights out since.
Really? So the lights are always on and keeps away any kind of bugs?
And no sheets?
No, I sleep on top of the covers.
Really?
Tiny,
now this is fascinating. And what do you sleep in? Do you have a dressing gown?
Usually I should have pajamas.
Right.
But sometimes I don't, and sometimes I just wear a shirt, usually I don't keep my legs covered.
Really? Now, why is that? Is there a reason?
It feels better.
It does. And you keep the room cool, air-conditioned, or you...
Fresh air. I will use cold air sometimes, but I don't use any of these conditioners. I don't like the heat on either.
Right.
However...
You like to go with the elements.
But when I go to hotels...
You sleep with underwear on?
No,
never.
Usually I have to get pajamas when I get. When I remind myself, I usually sleep with pajamas on.
All right, so then you keep the lights on, and you're in the hotel
on top of the covers.
On top of the covers.
Right.
Now, that's the fascinating thing here. Why on top?
Because I don't have to make the bed, and it looks new. And also, sometimes I do sleep under the covers, but I got to make sure that, especially in hotels, small hotels, there's dogs. They let dogs in, and when that happens, if the dog sleeps sleeps in, on the same sheets and covers, they, you know what fleas they carry.
Right.
And so that's why Carolina...
I never considered that.
Oh, yes. When there's dogs in hotels, you never know what, little mutts, whatever, that they can go right in the bed.
Animals are not meant to be in the house. Am I correct?
Well, they can be in a certain house, in your house, yes. The dog house, but I mean, definitely not on the bed because they could carry worms.
Worms and fleas.
It happened in one hotel in Brooklyn in 75.
Where you got worms.
Oh.
Did you actually get a case of the worms?
No. But there's something in the bed, and they had to take the whole mattress off.
So you read about this, and you said, hey, look, I don't want this happening to me.
Well, I was in the...
You were there?
It happened to him.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, my.
Unbelievable.
Wow. Tiny knows a lot of stuff, man.
Well, only through experience and going through that.
Yeah, what is being it, on Papa the road, Fui? You learn all these things.
You know who just arrived here?
Who?
Mrs. Tiny Tim.
Oh, is that right?
Yes.
Oh.
Now, I put her in the lobby because I didn't feel right putting a room with Ms. Warner.
Yeah. Now,
right,
what is it?
That was correct.
Tiny, you're here with Vanessa Warner, the beautiful stripper.
Who looks lovely today. We haven't talked to her yet.
And your wife is here. Would it be bad? We haven't even gotten to her yet.
Right, yeah.
We might need a whole 3 hours with Tiny.
Oh, well, Mr. Gary, she can stay with her. She wants to stay with her.
You know, and Tiny,
you don't want her on the air?
Oh, it's up to you.
I wouldn't mind. I'd be interested to hear what she has to say.
Yeah, maybe you can have a reconciliation here. Maybe you can straighten out their marriage.
Reconcile about because, you know, it's still talking. But the thing is...
Well, let me just meet her for a second. Do you mind, Tiny? Then we'll throw her the hell out of here so we can get back to you.
Tiny is saying the marriage is over.
The marriage is over.
Still friends.
Well, she told me that.
Is it?
She told me that.
Let me find out what's going on here. I don't... let me intervene.
I haven't had an affair with her since 89.
Is that right?
Really?
And she's still your wife.
Yeah, well, I don't believe in divorce. If she gets a divorce and stayed in New York, I'll have to give it to her.
Does she want the divorce?
She sure does.
Why won't you give it to her? Because you're religiously, you will not give a divorce.
Yeah, I'll believe divorce. Once together, always together. Miss Vicky had the state of Jersey give it to her back in 77.
Right.
And I couldn't afford to come back from Florida to contest it.
Right.
You know, but you would have.
You sure would have.
You're damn right.
Even though she committed adultery on me, too.
I'll find out why she stepped down on you. Let me handle it. Consider this my favor. She's tough?
Oh, yeah.
Really? Very careful.
I wish I had that Bud Light, Bud Ice now.
Ice Bud.
You need something to calm you down.
Yeah, you need an ice. Bring in an ice ice draft. We'd love an ice draft?
Yes.
Gary, bring in an ice draft, will you, for Tiny? Got to settle his nerves here. His wife's here.
His wife is real
tough. I don't want Tiny wigging out on me. Tiny, bring in an ice draft. Wow, you're hot.
Oh, my God.
Boy, Tiny, hey, man, she is hot.
Hello?
Wow. Oh, Tiny.
How are you,
Kiss hello? Nothing wrong with that. Don't touch Tiny. Just cleaned himself. All right.
Do we have a chair?
No. Sit down. That's right. We'll get a chair. Now, I just want to do a quickie here with you. You're a very, very beautiful woman. There is no doubt.
Look at her micro-mini.
Your body is exceptional. Am I correct?
Who are you asking?
No, not Tiny. You.
Are you asking me?
Yeah.
Oh, well, I'm pleased.
All right, but the point is you married Tiny, and Tiny felt that you were with other guys behind his back. Is this true?
Tiny loved me.
He did.
So very
not
much.
Love.
He still loves you. Still loves you.
Tiny loves me so very much.
Right. Yeah. There's your ice draft, Tiny.
Thank you very much.
He exaggerates his feelings of paranoia and fear of losing me, and he has been excessively jealous.
I can see why. She is a beautiful woman, Tiny. To hold on to her would be very difficult.
Well, I want to say to the point of almost losing his mind or making everybody around him lose their minds.
Well, he loves his wife.
You're saying Tiny was upset.
It was really a figment of his imagination.
Oh, I see. So you weren't cheating.
No.
Well, Tiny might have evidence. I don't know.
No,
Tiny's an excellent man.
Couldn't have evidence.
So you mean you are still in love with Tiny?
I'm not really in love with Tiny now.
Right. But you couldn't convince him. You couldn't convince him that you weren't cheating.
That's right. And it was very destructive.
It was.
It ruined the marriage.
And I didn't understand him that well. You know, we're going to be married 10 years on June 26th.
10 years.
That's right. We're going to have big anniversary parties all over town.
So you want a divorce from Tiny? Tiny doesn't believe in divorce.
We talk about it.
You do. Tiny, you would prefer to just stay married.
Mm.
You would.
It's very difficult.
I don't divorce anyone.
Still is.
You won't divorce anyone.
If she wants a divorce, the state of New York has to give it to her. I will contest it.
He still is very negative.
Well, he's a very religious man. He does believe. I know this about Tiny. I don't say I know him well, but I do know that he believes once you are married, that's it. You are married.
Well, I respect him for that, and
right.
I feel the same way.
So you don't want a divorce?
Wait, Tiny, she's some knockout.
Miss Quivers is talking to
Tiny, she's some knockout.
Oh, yeah, beautiful woman.
And you two, were lovers, woman. Tiny?
Pardon?
You two were lovers?
Wait a second, I think
he gave this to me. Hey, Tiny, with her, you only would have sex to have children, true?
Well, yes, but if she doesn't want to have any, as it happened in the marriage, then I can't go without nothing if I'm married to someone.
Right.
If I am married to someone, if I'm not married to someone, it's another story.
Right.
But if I'm married to someone and they don't want to have the kids, I can't say, well, go ahead, you deceive me, I'm going to get a divorce. But the thing is, I have to bear with it, but I can't go in a marriage without nothing. And so no matter what type, no matter how I'm pleased for a minute or two, it's like heaven, but only in marriage.
Oh, so now...
Robin, help me out here.
What he's saying is they did it.
Yeah, they did it.
Oh, yes. Oh, of course.
Wow.
Oh, I wouldn't ever... Oh, are you kidding?
I'll tell you something. What are you, a model or something?
I was a model.
God, look at you.
People ask me all the time if I start.
But, Tony, you really know how to get babes.
Well, I praise the good Lord for the eyes of beauty. I met Elizabeth Taylor in 1947 when she was 15.
Yeah.
I praise the good Lord for the eyes of beauty. Just to, not to get off the subject, 1 second. Amy Fisher.
Yes. You were attracted to her?
A lot of people. Oh, I read her book.
Yeah.
I wrote a letter to her lawyer.
Right.
And to another thing with Miss Bobbitt. Lorena
Stay away
Bobbitt.
From both of them.
You wrote to Lorena Bobbitt?
And to Miss Fisher's lawyer.
Right.
Saying that when I read her book, My Story, just half of the book, because it was terrible what happened to Mr. Butterfuckle's wife.
Right. Awful.
Unbelievable. But the thing is that, you know, she's a woman who is obsessed with one man.
But you don't want to, you don't want to get shot in the head. Stay away from
her. Oh, no, but I just wrote that to keep going and to try to be a lawyer. I think she could be a lawyer, or she could continue with her art. That's all I did.
I see. Did you feel, when you met Tiny, was it love at first sight?
Oh, there definitely was a chemistry.
Really?
Yes. Our eyes met. It was very classic.
And then, of course, Tiny would not touch you until you were married.
Oh, he was a perfect gentleman.
Right.
It was a difficult... It was a real find at the time.
Right.
Now, you don't think there's any way of resurrecting your love for Tiny?
Oh, there'll always be a dear love for him. Always. Uh-huh.
Yeah, I notice whenever he's around, you always come to see him.
He is my family, and so I don't think that can...
Ever change.
Ever change.
But now, what, do you have a boyfriend or something?
Well,
you're living with a guy?
No, there's nothing like that.
Really?
Now, the only thing is...
Were you a virgin when you met Tiny?
Just about.
Really?
We didn't do anything until we were married.
No kidding.
So... At this point, it seems as though I should get a life. I think he's in agreement of that also. It's been a very long time.
I say, Tiny, get back with her.
Yeah.
I tell you, she's hot.
You don't want to move to Des Moines, is that it?
Well, it's not a question of that.
You got to go with your man.
We talked about it, and the feasibility of me moving to Des Moines and
I don't see you in Des Moines.
Doesn't
not in that outfit.
The logistics and...
I see. So what are you doing now?
The opportunity isn't there.
So what are you doing now?
I'm involved in promoting clubs and special events for charity.
You are some hot number. I mean, Tiny, if you don't mind me saying about your wife, I don't want you wigging out on me, but...
She is a beautiful woman,
right.
And, you know, it is difficult to live with me.
Right.
I mean, there's no doubt.
Was it hard for you? You couldn't be with Tiny?
Well, I'm pretty easy to get along with, generally.
Right.
And,
was she allowed to share your room or anything? You like separate rooms. Right. You wanted separate rooms.
But he's difficult. There's no question about that.
You didn't like having separate rooms from Tiny?
Well, whatever he wanted was all right. I mean, the idea when you're with somebody is you want them to live their life and be happy. So you do what you can to adjust.
Sounds reasonable.
And get along.
She sounds reasonable here, Tiny.
There were difficulties and things that would make it...
Did you sleep on top of the covers also? You did.
Yeah.
Sounds like the perfect girl. This is not testimony, but I Tiny don't recall that.
Well, Miss Jan is a beautiful woman.
Right.
And definitely everywhere she goes, they look at her.
Now, have you been begging Tiny for a divorce? Is that it?
There are times that it's very difficult.
You would like a divorce.
Well, how often do you two talk to each other?
Seems as
oh, very rarely now.
Very rarely.
Really?
But how did she know you were even going to be here today? How did you know that Tiny would
we
be
here? I told
you do stay in touch.
I told her that.
I see.
You know,
so you're happy to see her? Or,
I'm
okay.
Happy to see
her. We used to talk all the time, every day, a few times a day.
Well, if I was Tiny, I'd hold on to you. I'll tell you that.
Oh,
let me tell you, man. I wouldn't lose you. She can make me happy. I'll tell you that. We wouldn't be on top of the covers, I'll tell you that. Right in the tub. You know what I'm saying?
That's wonderful. It's just that, you know, wherever she goes, they look at her.
I think you got jealous maybe a little bit too, right?
I was very jealous.
Well, the thing, always jealous.
Right.
I mean, I believe a man and woman should be jealous of each other, providing they can hold the line and not go to insanity.
Right.
I mean, there's got to be a passion. There's got to be a jealousy. You know, married couples belong together. There's no interference. Sure, I'd be looking if someone even talked to her. I'd want to know who it is.
Right.
There is a validity for jealousy.
Got bad, huh?
In a marriage.
Yeah. It was bad.
Destructive.
It was destructive. Right, yeah. Well, all right. So now the two of you are apart, and that'll be it.
Oh, I feel so bad.
And we love Tiny. We hate to see him in pain. That's all.
I can't. The only pain, I'm not in pain. It's just that.
But then, Tiny, you can't be married to anyone else.
Yeah, I don't think you can be married to anyone else because you're going to stay married to her. So how are you ever going to marry someone
else? That's the way it is in this world.
Right.
I mean.
But you're allowed to be with other women. After all, you are.
Talk to them.
Right.
And, you know, if something happens, like kissing or anything like that, that could happen.
He calls me and tells me all about
it. That's right.
That's right.
I have the highest loss to answer to.
Want my advice?
Tell me.
Less marriage, more ice draft beer. You know what I'm saying? All right, let me take a little break. Hey, by the way, Tiny tonight at the Twilight Zone. Are you going to be at the Twilight Zone with Tiny? Are you going to go watch him?
We didn't talk about it. I would be very nice to see him.
Because I'm going
to
be bad seeing her there either, I'll tell you that.
Well, that's
it would affect the performance. I don't know.
Oh, it's always a thrill to have.
And Tiny was a great lover? True?
Oh no.
I don't know
why they call him Tiny.
Really? Congratulations.
Very nice. But really, I was a bad lover. I am not a good lover.
Is that true?
She's very nice to say this, but the fact is I'm not, 3 minutes, it's all over.
Really? Hey, join the club. 3 minutes would be long for me.
I got you, pal.
But, I know what you're saying.
But the main thing, as much as I can...
at least you're a fun guy.
To try to please her, whatever.
Definitely. Right. You did whatever you could to please her. Well, after 3 minutes, and then you just get right back into it again, and then be a little longer.
That's tough.
Well, you know what it is? She's so beautiful that you look at her, you run over. Yeah, it's almost over. Right. Am I correct?
And she's more beautiful with the lipstick off.
Really? Oh, you don't like it with any makeup?
Oh, she looks good that way, too.
Yeah.
That is true.
She's near perfect as far as I'm concerned. What are you, 38, 24, 36?
Sounds right.
No, I don't mean you. I mean Tiny. So anyway, there you go.
But it's just that I'm just very thrilled,
Right.
What can I say?
Right, right. Well, here she is. All right. Hey, you know how to get hot women. You ought to write a book about that. How to get a woman.
Yeah.
Because Tiny's not like classically handsome or anything, right? Tiny, you're not. So the thing is, when
I'm very ugly from the standpoint.
I wouldn't say that, but listen to this. I mean, she's perfect.
Beautiful woman. Yeah, she is perfect. You're right.
Were you suspicious? Did you think she wanted you for your money?
Yes. All for the fame.
All for the fame.
But then she said a point. Miss Jan said a point. Very true. Well, why do you want me? And you want me because I have the looks you want. And she's absolutely right.
Right. You were using each other in a sense.
Well, yes, in that way.
Right.
But still, whatever comes into the marriage was really meant to make them. There's nothing wrong in wanting looks.
Miss Jan, did you want Tiny for his money and his fame?
Well, I knew his situation with the money.
Right.
And I wasn't marrying him for his fame. I married him for love.
You did.
Well, but even if she did, I mean, one has to give something. There's nothing wrong with that as long as the truth is made known. I can't see how Billy Joel and Christine Brinkley broke up.
Right.
I mean, this other beautiful angel. I mean.
How's it possible?
Because they got tired and bored with each other. And I mean, one has to work at all marriages to bring it back to where it was. We have to suffer for everything in life, to make it big, to make it small, to just have success in life.
Yeah, Miss Jan, you got to stick with Tiny.
Well, he's got all the right ideas.
Yes, he does. Just doesn't work out for some reason.
He would love to do everything just perfectly.
Right.
It just doesn't always work out.
Well, that's sad. Do you know how to clean a tub?
He does all that.
Tiny is great.
I don't do it well enough for him to make.
What kind of accent is that? You got a bit of an accent.
Do I have an accent?
Yeah, a little bit.
People think I don't know.
A little accent.
Where are you from? I'm from New York.
Oh, you are?
Really?
That's a New York accent. That's what I thought. Anyway, Tiny's going to be the Twilight Zone tonight in Long Beach, and
that was the page six.
Yeah. Hey, Tiny. If we say goodbye to Miss Jan, you think you can hang in there just a little bit longer? Yeah, I don't mind. No, I got a couple more questions for you, Miss Jan. Quite frankly, you're too damn distracting with your outfit. A little too hot for me, I'll tell you that.
Today.
Yeah, but hang out a little bit, all right? And we'll.
I think it's tough for Tiny to see her.
Yeah, because it's tough for Tiny. It distracts him a little bit.
What it is, I'm very happy to see her. You know, it's just that there's so many things you don't know.
Meh.
There are so many things I don't know. Or
yeah, right. About
so
you.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, he doesn't know about
that. We don't know about you.
Oh, well, nobody's really bothered to ask, have they?
Well, if I knew the question, I'd ask it.
Anyway.
What don't I know?
I mean, basically, I mean, unbelievable beauty. I remember I paid $65 to get her picture when I first met her in 83.
I brought that picture with me.
Really?
Yes, I have it.
$65 I paid just to get a snapshot.
Really?
When we first met.
And nothing, and that was summer 14th, 1983.
How long did you court her for?
6 months.
6 months, and then she agreed to marry you?
Yeah, I would have married her quick if I had the cash.
Right.
I don't like to waste time.
Right.
You know what you want, and you want to go get it.
Yeah, well, instead of...
And did Tiny call you every night? Was he, like, wild for you? I mean...
He is very, very romantic.
Really?
In fact, when I met him, I don't believe he had my home telephone number. He only knew where I worked.
Yeah.
And he and his chauffeur did drop me off that evening. But he sent flowers to my office the next day.
Let me see the picture that Tiny paid
$65. And nobody would believe that it was really Tiny Tim. Because
really?
He signed the card, Tiny Tim. And then when I came home at night, I had flowers at home, too.
Wow. Let me see the picture that Tiny paid $65 for. I got to see this.
Tanya Harding. Tanya Harding. I wrote a song for her.
Did you?
Though you are sighing, though you are crying, and everything has gone wrong, the world is waiting. Keep right on skating. Skate to the ice skater song.
Really?
I just saw her picture there.
Interesting. Yeah, there she is. You're right. You're absolutely. You like her?
Oh, I like her spunk.
You do? Tiny's got, he likes everyone.
He's an amazing man. He's on top of everything.
Now, what is this, a nude picture, Tiny, of your wife, or just a regular picture?
This is a picture when I first met her. I saw this picture. $65.
Who did you pay $65 to?
Why would the picture be? He gave it to me.
Really?
He
paid you $65.
He wanted blow-ups, and he wanted a few of them.
Let me see that. Let me see that picture.
Oh, this looks good.
Let me see that. Wow. $65, huh? I'll give you $85.
Yeah, let me see.
I'm a married man, Tiny. You don't have to worry, be jealous of me.
I have a
don't cheat.
Pictures here of you, Howard.
Is that right?
That's right.
No, don't show them to Tiny.
Every marriage
has its problems. That's absolutely true. Let me take a break here, Tiny. Let me take a break. We got a couple more minutes left with Tiny. I could spend 9 hours with Tiny, quite frankly.
So you want to say hello to Vanessa, too?
We'll say hello to Vanessa also. Wonderful. I don't want to leave her out.
She has a project.
Yes.
She's working on something today.
Yeah, but I still want to hear more about hemorrhoids and living in Iowa.
One thing, before I leave, if I can just use this microphone.
Yes.
Just to sing a song.
Please, go ahead. Well, let me do a break, and then we'll do it. Okay.
Thank you.
We'll be back right after these words. So, Miss Jan, do you mind if we talk to Tiny for a while? And if you, it's okay? All right.
Thank you.
We just wanted you to... Gary kept saying to Miss Jan, come on this way. Miss Jan was resisting going. I think you like being on the microphone, right, Miss Jan?
I like being where the action is.
Where the action is. All right, well, we'll get back to you. Let me just finish up with Tiny here. I'll see you later, Miss Jan. Nice dress. You wearing stockings? Yeah? Don't look it. It's hot. But you're a white boy. That's some ex-wife. Mama mia.
She is beautiful.
Yeah, man.
I still have to disagree on some of the things she said.
Right.
I think she did see. I've seen other men, and I...
But you never caught her in the act.
Right.
No, I never did. However, she was caught in the act by somebody else when I was in Canada.
I see.
You know,
you do tend to be possessive of your women, though, right?
Well, absolutely.
Yeah.
I get a love. It's just like finding $1 million. You want to hold on to it.
Right.
And basically...
But although maybe you smother the women with
the
love.
Yeah, maybe you squeeze too hard. Yeah.
Well, maybe you might be right there, Ms. Quivers, but the point is, you know, if what breaks up so many marriages is honey, do what you want, go what you want.
Right.
Really, that
you got to you're old fashioned. You rule with hey, listen.
I wish I did rule with an iron hand. I say I just rule with a tinfoil hand.
Right.
But the thing is, I would say that there is I'll tell you one thing. There is when you find a gem, you don't want to let it go. Marriage is forever.
Well, let me tell you something. That Miss Jan is I hope you don't mind this phrase, but some piece of ass. I mean, I never saw anything like it.
Well, she is a beautiful woman.
Holy mackerel, what a body. When you saw her naked, you must have gone out of your mind.
Oh,
holy cow.
Well, I tell you.
Oh, man.
Am I right? I went out of my mind without her getting
up. I know. I mean, and then you must have been like, oh, man, I can't believe she's mine. And then you're crazy.
Yes, and then, but you remember, every marriage, and this is the worst enemies of all marriages.
Right.
What breaks up every marriage is the enemy called tiredness, boredom, and losing that loving feeling. And in every marriage, that happens.
How long did you hold on to her? I mean, you know, in a real way. I mean, how long did you manage to keep the love going for a while?
I would say...
A couple of months?
I would say probably a month.
Really?
No,
as far... No, no, well, she got tired of me. I got tired of her.
Boy, I would dress her up in peignoirs. I would dress her up in peignoirs, everything, nightgowns, everything. You know what I'm saying?
It doesn't matter how
high heels.
Beautiful they are.
Really?
When tiredness comes in, the most beautiful woman is like a stone wall.
Right. I mean,
everything comes from the heart,
right.
The emotions, the grace of God.
You know what I think's hard for you?
Tell me.
You are so particular in terms of, you know, the cleanliness and all that, and what you eat and all that, and sleeping on top of the covers, that, like, any woman could never live up to that lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? You know, you're very particular. You'd be very difficult to live with.
I'm
going to
tell you something on the air.
Okay, go ahead.
Which I never intended to say.
Go ahead.
I didn't want to say it in front of Miss Jan here, although she knows this.
Okay.
She knows this. It's not behind her back. She knew this from 1991.
Go ahead.
I have found the eternal love.
You have?
The eternal love. I have a picture of her right here.
Go ahead.
She is 26 today. I met her on May 19th, 1988.
Go ahead.
At the Dada Club. I was still married to Miss Jan, and Miss Jan has left me every year. So, I mean, what can I tell you?
Right.
But I'm going to show you. Miss Stephanie is her name.
Go ahead.
Forget the love. I just hope she likes me. But...
Has she ever expressed interest in you?
Never.
Never.
But the thing is...
So this is an unrequited love.
Oh.
He's in pain. Yeah, I can tell you suffering from this.
He knows if I ever get to heaven... that I hope he makes me another Miss Stephanie.
Right.
And dwell with her forever. Miss Jagger have...
Have you expressed this to Miss Stephanie?
Yes.
And what does she say?
Tape. She's amused.
She's amused? Right. And nothing like a woman laughing at you.
Yeah, really.
Right.
Yeah.
The thing is, I'm going to show you a picture here.
Let me see it.
This one here, I have to...
I want to see if she's as good as Miss Jan.
Oh, everyone has their talents. It's just like finding a $1,000 bill 10 times.
Right.
Everyone has their talents. Miss Jan is a beautiful angel. Classic always. She is in my heart forever.
Let me see, Miss Stephanie. Let me see the picture.
This is a recent picture. Last year.
Let me see.
This is not the best picture of her.
Oh, yeah, that's a knockout. Oh, yeah.
You can love her eternally.
Like a farm girl.
I said, you know you can love her eternally.
Oh, yeah. What a statement.
I could love her eternally.
She has something that no other woman ever had.
Really?
That I've met. Beauty, yes.
But I'm telling you, it's hard for the women to... I mean, you are so particular. Like, you even know what kind of cleansing materials you need.
Who would know that it's Ajax has now got more grit than Comet?
Right.
They killed themselves when they took out the grit. I know it was a few years ago. You know, they wanted to make it smoother. They were trying to copy Bonhomie, which doesn't work.
All right, Tiny, let me ask you this. Because I really want to put some rap on this thing. First of all, I want to remind everyone that tonight you'll be at the Twilight Zone, formerly Page Six, Tiny, in Long Beach, performing, and hopefully I'm looking forward to seeing you do You Think I'm Sexy, the same way you did it on the Johnny Carson show. But who knows? It's a surprise if you do it or not.
Whatever you do.
Whatever you do is good with us. But the point is, you're out there in Iowa, you're in the hotel, you sleep on top
Where's
of the
Miss
sheets.
Stephanie? Is she out there in Iowa?
No, never. She's in Denton, Texas.
You've got to get a hold of her.
Well,
if you could score with her, that would be the ultimate, right?
Well, she's angry with me, too, now.
Why?
Miss Jan told me the other night that she was just a puppet for my agent out there who used to like her. And I called my agent up and said...
What a complicated lifetime he has.
And then I said the same thing. I was drinking a few beers.
Yeah.
Right now, the latest with her is that she is writing me a long letter. Because my agent sent her a tape of what I said when I was a little tipsy.
Oh, boy.
But anyway, but if I ever get to heaven...
Right, you'll have Miss Stephanie.
It makes me another Miss Stephanie, like it makes a million blades of grass.
Right.
A million...
yeah, why can't God make a million blades of Miss Stephanie? That's what I'm saying.
He can.
He can.
That's why if I get to heaven, he'll make me another one.
I hope so. I pray that happens for you.
You don't think you're going to get her in this lifetime, is that it?
Well, I doubt that.
You need to get a more mature woman. Maybe not go for the look so much. Go for maybe...
Yeah,
someone
for a man who's approaching 65,
right.
Maybe a little older woman.
Yeah, right. Maybe no, he can't. He loves the young girls. Tiny's only attracted to perfection.
No. Oh, Miss Grimms, let me answer that. First of all,
maybe you should go after an ugly woman or something.
Well, let me tell you something.
Mm-hmm.
And Miss Jan told me this. Her mind is brilliant. The more average or less than average a woman is, the more she knows to give what pretty girls don't give.
Ah.
You know, and
good
that
sex.
Is very true.
Good sex.
You know, it's right. And believe you me, I mean...
The uglier the girl, the better the sex.
Well, that right. would be very true.
Yes.
I remember one girl, I don't know if I can tell you this, but I remember one girl, a shocking thing happened back in 1971.
Yes.
I mean, 75, Miss Vicky left me then. I was in Chicago, and she said to me... I was wrong in having up to the room, but she.
You got weak and you.
Yeah,
had her,
right.
You sinned. Go ahead. Yeah.
I got on the. I was on the bed and she said, "Close your eyes." I just said, "Don't do nothing." She said to me, "And just tell me what you like when I touch." And then she said, "Ask me if it feels good." And then she touched my hands.
Yeah.
Then she touched my chin. Then she touched my eyes. Then she touched, you know, my neck. And then she kept on touching.
Right.
You know, and
the best part of all, right?
But that was a great style.
Right.
So,
and
really,
that was an ugly girl.
That's right.
Right.
You
know who you need? You need a girl that looks like Barbara Bush. She'll worship you. I'm telling you. Am I correct?
Miss Bush is a lovely woman.
Yeah, lovely woman, but not the best looking.
Right now she's getting on in years.
Oh, that's right. Uh-huh. That's right.
No, sorry, but the thing is...
Turn the lights off and pretend it's Miss Jam.
I'm sure she was. Oh, no, I can't pretend. No, that's one thing...
You will never do that. That's the worst sin of all.
I can't pretend.
All right, so let me just wrap up here somehow. It's impossible to wrap up with you because there's so many facets. But seriously, it's fascinating to me your whole life.
Right.
You're in the hotel... And cooking your own meals is impossible because you're in a hotel.
Yeah, I don't eat cooked food anyway.
You don't? Everything is raw. You've stocked the shelves in your room?
Well, unless I order from, you know, Pizza Man or Chinese food, everything is either apples or canned foods.
Now, canned foods, I'm surprised that you would
right from the can.
Really? What are you eating from the can these days?
Beans. A lot of beans.
Cold beans, like just right out of the can?
Right from the can.
Right from the can.
Yeah, and talking of beans, I'm at S&W has a great best brand of kidney beans.
S&W canned kidney beans.
You can crunch them. You can crunch them as you chew them. And a good bean, you can... It's not too soft. You can crunch it. And definitely, S&W has a great brand.
Right.
Now, sometimes I watch the gas.
Yes.
I do watch the gas.
What do you do if you get gas?
Well, if you had a lot of beans, that can happen.
Right.
So I will have two or three cans of beans sometimes, put mustard inside of some of them. And
mustard in the beans?
And don't go out for about 4 hours.
Right. That'll delay it. Well, Tiny, you are always fascinating.
You're not going to say hello to Vanessa?
Let me say hello to Vanessa. So you brought her in.
Oh, please.
Vanessa, come on in here. Bring in Vanessa Warner. She's from our pay-per-view special. She was the girl who stripped down and made herself into a human sundae. Tiny was a real big fan of her. Somehow he's hooked up with her.
Yeah, I don't know what they're doing together, but she's here today.
Yeah, she's real hot, man. I dig her, too. Hey, Vanessa, how you doing? Vanessa, why don't you marry Tiny?
Oh, listen, so many millions of men want her.
Right.
You know that.
Would you marry her, Tiny?
Oh,
in a minute. Yeah,
so
she's hot, man.
But the thing is, she's got millions of men.
Also, what? One more can't hurt. So, are you attracted to Tiny at all? Is that what's going on here?
He's actually a really awesome person.
Really?
He really is.
Yes.
Yeah, he's called a couple of times, and when we've spoken on the phone, he always has just the perfect thing to say.
Yeah.
Like, and he calls it just the right time.
But did
too.
You tell Tiny you're into lesbianism? He doesn't mind that?
We haven't really talked about it too much.
Tiny, were you aware of that?
I wasn't, but it doesn't matter, because I am interested only, she was so great on your show,
yes.
And I believe she should have won, and basically, anything, as long as
look at the hips on her, Tiny, never mind all that nonsense.
Wherever she goes, it's wonderful.
Right.
And I'm glad that she's with me today, and I hope you are, because the world has to see you.
Vanessa,
you
wearing...
I worked in places where girls liked each other,
yeah.
The Page Three.
Nothing wrong with that.
As a matter of opinion,
right.
But it's just that I can say that I can can see why they're attracted to each other.
You wouldn't want to have two women in bed with you at the same time?
I would rather have.
Yes.
I would rather have a woman who was in love with me and did like other women marry me than someone not to tell me what they're doing and cheat with a guy.
I see. Very good.
Ah, I get you. It took me a little while to figure that out.
Yes, you'd rather have a woman cheat with another woman.
No, I would not. But I'm just saying, out of the two, I prefer that.
Yeah, I'm with you. I don't mind that.
I think, you know,
Vanessa, look at the hips on you.
I think Vanessa's in love.
With who?
With a guy.
Yes. Is that right? Who are you in love with?
A man named Rob Martin.
Oh. Yeah. I'm telling you, I'm wasting time with her then.
Great talent.
You wearing panties with that dress?
Panties? No.
Wow, good for you. Tiny, I know you wanted to ask. I had to ask for you. And no bra, right?
Well.
That's a bra?
Yeah, I have a bra on.
Oh. Anyway, so what is going on with you? Do you want to tell us anything that's going on? Or?
Well, right now I'm getting ready for Miss Nude World.
Oh.
Nude World pageant. It's the week of May 30th.
When's the last time you saw her naked, Tiny?
Oh, I don't think I ever did.
Well, except for the pay-per-view.
Topless.
Well, there was whipped cream there.
Would you like her to strip right now for us so we can see? She would take her clothes off for us right
I
now.
I believe she has what you say.
Would you really? You don't want to see her naked? I do. Vanessa, would you get naked for us?
I don't think I could.
Right now?
You won't. You're not going to watch, Tiny? You'll watch.
Well, I mean, I'd watch right now.
You would, right? If you would insult her by not watching?
Don't get me wrong.
Go ahead.
I have gone to topless and bottomless places.
I know you have.
I've only gone there to watch the beautiful faces.
Right. That's legitimate.
Believe it or not, everyone has that trade. And
you don't want to see Vanessa naked right now? I do.
Well, of course.
Do you mind if I see her naked? Vanessa, do you mind showing us your do you? What?
Sorry.
You show us?
You saw it already.
What is it?
You know, Ann Magnuson's in the guest lounge.
Oh.
Well, we can never get enough. All right, Vanessa, forget it. I don't know. I don't know how Tiny feels about it. Tiny, you would like to see her naked, right?
Well, that's a hard question to answer.
Because how could that be hard? That's an easy one.
What I would not like to do, I think I'm trying to say, is to put her on the spot.
Yeah, we don't want to put you on the spot. It's a girl who takes her clothes off every 10 minutes for guys.
I have no idea. She's going to be in a Miss Nude World.
She's going to be in Miss Nude World, but we can't see her naked. All right, anyway. Vanessa, thank you so much for coming in.
It's in Chicago, the week of May 30th to June 4th at a club called Headliners.
Uh-huh.
And there'll be girls from Australia, from Canada, from Japan.
All over the
Russia,
world.
Yeah.
Tiny,
we wish you luck.
Tiny, I want to thank you for coming in. And we're looking forward to your show tonight at the Twilight Zone, formerly Page 6 in Long Beach tonight. You'll be out there doing all your great hits and all the songs. And we're glad you're back on the show after 5 years.
Mr. Stern, thanks for being so nice. Ms. Quivers, Mr. Jeremy.
It's always good to see you.
And thanks for everything.
Right.
I want to thank Mr. Glenn Knight again from Headline Talent.
Absolutely.
For having me here as well.
Yes, and Vanessa, thanks for taking your clothes off.
Oh,
okay,
Vanessa,
anyway.
Okay.
All right.
Time.
All right.
Give her a break.
Thanks, Tony. We're going to take a break. Ann Magnuson is here. There's someone who will take her clothes off. Right? And we'll be back right after these words. It's good having Tiny on. He's always fun.
You forget.